another unboxing.
It's fit in the front of the middle.
Well, friends, welcome back. Thank you for tuning in again. Another episode of the Backyard Warrior. And today we have another unboxing video. This box came from Grill Grates. If you're not familiar with Grill Grates, they make grill grates for pretty much everything. So I got this from my smoker, the Workhorse 1975 for the Cowboy grill. So we're gonna open this box and see if they fit first, because it says 24 inch and the firebox is 24 inch. If they fit, that's fine. If not, I can use them for something else. Without any further ado, let's open this bad boy and see what's inside. This is part of, I believe, Black Friday deal. I had this box for a while. I never had a chance to open it. It's now almost February. We got some paperwork. Packaging is good. No complaints so far. Like, as always. And this is not the first time I purchased grill grates. I have them for pretty much all my grills. Highly recommended. A very good addition to any smoker or grill. Oh wait, these are sharp. So these are 24 by 5, so 3 of them, that makes 15. And I hope this fit in the firebox. And now we're gonna find out if these fit or no. Unfortunately, these don't fit. So
after a trip to the shop, let's try the grill grates again. And they fit perfect. Nice. I did cut an inch from it. It was 24. Now it's 23 inch. And it fit perfect in this Cowboy grill here. We have 3 panels. Each panel is 5 inch, so I have a total of 15 inch wide and 23 long. And you can use them however you want. Place them anywhere in the grill. This is perfect. You can even flip them. Now we have a flat griddle we can use for smash burgers or whatever you want to cook on it. So I was lucky enough to have a shop by the house 2 minutes away. I went in there, asked him to cut an inch from this. He said, yeah, no problem. He did it in a couple minutes. All right, so now these already washed. I'm gonna wash them again. So this is not necessary. You don't need to do this to your smoker. It's just me, I like to add stuff, make it work better. Just like the grate in the bottom, I like to add these. Down the middle, just like that, and we have two beautiful steaks here. One is thicker than the other one, no big deal. Maybe a little bit of this fat cap, not much. kosher salt here. I used diamond crystal. It's called Libra. There's a big piece of meat though. Don't be scared. Put in a wire rack, let the air circulate. In the fridge it goes for a few hours. Here I have some pecan wood I'm using today. Some olive oil for a binder, a little flavor as well. Since these are already salted, all I have to add is some garlic powder, some black pepper. Of course, you can do any seasoning you want, it's up to you. For me, I'll just stick with, I'll keep it simple and do the garlic powder and the black pepper. Here's some coarse black pepper. These will sit here for a little bit until the smoker comes up to temp and we start cooking. Alright, smoker is up to temp. I'm gonna place these steaks on the far left with the bone facing the box. And I have some probes here, these steaks, so we don't overcook them. That's good. Alright, so these will cook until they reach 125 and we sear them in a firebox. So I'm doing the burn off on my Camp Chef burner. I got all the three panels here. This one is already changing color, which is a good sign. It was in the middle. I rotate them. There's more flame in the middle. So I'll do one by one and then flip them until all the three panels are like this. That's the color I'm looking for. All right. Now we're doing the other side. Start to get some color, which is good. Almost done. Very nice. So exactly an hour 15 minutes into this cook,
We're still at 250. Some wood in here. And steak is, I think the little one is a 129. The big one is a 111. These steaks looking good, nice color on them. The big one is at 120. This one is almost 125. Beautiful color. I think these are ready. Look at that color, beautiful. Now, warmer for a little bit until we get the firebox ready. In here. These are coming off the grill. Rest them for a little bit before we cut the dough, okay? All right, it's time to cut into this steak. We have some nice grill mark, good sear. A little bit of a char, which is not bad. On this steak, now you get both smokiness and a char from the direct heat. Take this rib first. I'm gonna nibble on this later on. And cut the cap. Now we have this beautiful eye that we're gonna cut and see how we did. Not bad, a good medium rare. Very moist, juicy. Beautiful, perfectly seasoned, nicely done. And like I said, you give both of words a little bit of a char, a little bit of smokiness. Perfect combination. This is it for this one. Thank you for tuning in. I hope you liked and enjoyed the content. Until the next one, stay safe and bye-bye.